Good morning. Today we are going to deal with lichenology, which is another second semester, which is from second semester BSc Botany course syllabus of Calicut University. Lichens are composite, slow-growing organisms formed by an intimate association between a fungus and a green algae or a cyanobacterium. Now, algae like Protococcus and cyanobacterium like Gliocapsa, Nostoc, Stygonema, or Revillaria can come into association with the fungus to form the lichen thallus. The fungal partner is usually called as mycobiont and the algal partner is called as phycobiont. Now, since we now know that other than cyanobacterium, green algae can also come into association, so the term phycobiont is nowadays replaced by the term photobiont. Now, some scientists consider this relationship as a master and slave relationship called as helotism, where the fungus is the master and algae is the slave. Now, this is in contrast to the earlier concept that algae and fungi, they get into mutual relationship. Now, based on the fungal partner, three groups of lichens can be recognized, namely ascolichens, basidiolichens and deuterolichens. Ascolichens, where the floating body is an apothecium, belong to the group Gymnocarpae, and those where the fruiting body is a perithecium belong to the group Pyrenocarpae. So these are the figures showing the various green algae and the cyanobacteria which can get into association with the fungus to form the lichen thallus, Protococcus, Gliocapsa, Nostoc, Stygonema and Revillaria. And these are the figures showing ascolichens and basidiolichens. Usnea is an ascolichen and Dictyonema is a basidiolichen. Now, based on habitat, the place where they grow, the lichens can be classified as saxicoles, corticoles, pterycoles, freshwater lichen and marine lichen. Now, saxicoles, they grow on rocks, example is Porina, Pornia, Santhoria. And corticoles, they grow on tree barks, example Parmelia, Usnea, etc. Pterycoles, they grow on soil, example is Cladonia. Freshwater lichens, Hymerelia is an example, and for marine lichens, Caloplaca is an example. Now, classification based on the nature of the thallus, classification where the lichens can be classified as crustose lichens, folios lichens, fruticose lichens and leprose lichens, where crustose lichens are also called as encrusting lichens and folios lichens are also called as leafy lichens and fruticose lichens are also called as shrubby lichens. Now, crustose lichens, the thallus is thin, flat and closely adherent to the substratum. It is very difficult to dislodge them. Examples, graphis, hematoma, lichenora, etc. In folios lichens, the thallus is flat, much lobed and leaf-like or scale-like, spreading over the substratum. Attached to the substratum only at certain points by means of structures called as rhizines. Examples are Parmelia, Peltigera, etc. Now, fruticose lichens are most conspicuous types of lichens with slender, much branched and shrubby thallus hanging from the substratum. Examples, Usnea, Cladonia, etc. Leprose lichens are lichens with some fungal hyphae surrounding one or more algal cells and they usually appear as dusty powder on the substratum. So, these are the figures representing the nature of the lichen thallus in crustose lichens, folios lichens, fruticose lichens and leprose lichens. Now, regarding the internal structure of lichens, the basic plan is almost the same in all types of lichens with just some minor variations. If the algal and fungal components of the thallus are almost uniformly distributed, the thallus is called as homeomerous, as in the case of crustose lichens. If the algal and fungal components are arranged in distinct cellular layers, then the thallus is called as heteromerous, as in the case of folios and fruticose lichens. So these are the figures showing the internal structure of homeomerous lichens and heteromerous lichens. In the case of homeomerous lichens, you can say that there is no distinct zonation. The hypha are loosely arranged and the algal cells are trapped in between these fungal hyphae. Whereas in the case of heteromerous lichens, you can see there is a distinct categorization into the upper cortex, lower cortex. There is a distinct algal zone and then the medulla zone. And there are structures called as ricines arising from the lower cortex, which help in attachment. In foliose lichens, there are four layers of different tissues, namely from outer side, upper cortex, algal layer, medulla, and lower cortex. The upper cortex is formed of vertical and closely packed interwoven fungal hyphae. Intercellular spaces are either absent or are filled with a gelatinous substance. The outer surface of the upper cortex may sometimes be a fine, septate, thick-walled, branched or unbranched hairs. The algal layer is formed mostly of algal cells intermingled with fungal hyphae. Now this layer is photosynthetic in function. And this layer was earlier termed as gonadal layer, as the algal layer was thought to be reproductive in nature. But now we know that this is not the case. Medulla is formed of thick-walled and loosely interwoven fungal hyphae with large intercellular spaces in between them. The inner cortex is formed of dark-colored, compact and closely packed fungal hyphae arranged parallel or perpendicular to the main axis of the thallus. Intercellular spaces between these hyphae are either absent or filled with a gelatinous material. The inner cortex gives out numerous hyphae called as rhizines that provide attachment to the substratum. In fruticose lichens also, the thallus is heteromerous but is radially symmetrical. It has three distinct zones, namely upper pseudocortex, middle algal zone, and the inner medulla. Pseudocortex is formed of thick-walled and compactly arranged fungal hyphae. Algal layer is formed of algal cells with fungal hyphae. This layer is photosynthetic. Medulla is formed of compact fungal hyphae, which lie parallel to the main axis of the thallus. Now, in some lichens, such as Usnea, there is a central core in addition to the surrounding medulla. Now, some peculiar structures in lichen thallus which are either vegetative or reproductive or both. They include breathing pores, siphellae, cephalodia, aishidia, and suridia. Now, breathing pores are localized depressions or cone-shaped areas for gas exchange between the thallus and the atmospheric air. They are seen on the upper surface of some foliose lichens. In them, the compact cortical hyphae are replaced by loosely interwoven hyphae to facilitate gaseous exchange. Siphellae are small circular pits or depressions in the lower cortex of some foliose lichens. They have definite form with an apical rim. They function as aerating organs and appear as cup-like white spots on the thallus. Siphellae open to the medulla to enable gaseous exchange. Siphellae, like cavities without definite form and apical rim, are called as pseudocyphellae. Cephalodia. These are small, hard and dark, gall-like or wart-like internal or external swellings on the upper surface of the thallus. A cephalodium is formed of algal cells enclosed by fungal hyphae. The fungal hyphae are normal, but the algal cells are different from those of other regions. Aishidia. These are stalked, branched or unbranched papillate outgrowths from the upper surface of lichen thallus. Each of them consists of algal and fungal components covered by a definite cortex. Their primary function is to increase the photosynthetic efficiency of lichens by increasing the surface area of the thallus. Sometimes they detach from the parent thallus and grow into a new thallus, thereby acting as vegetative reproductive bodies. Soridia are minute, rounded and bud-like outgrowths or bodies on the general surface of the thallus or in pustule-like areas called as soralia. They may appear as grayish powder on the surface. They are formed in the algal layers in places where the overlying upper cortex is absent. Each soridium consists of one or more algal cells surrounded by fungal hyphae. The soridia detach from the thallus and get disseminated by wind. So they also serve as vegetative reproductive bodies. Now, reproduction in lichens can be by three methods: vegetative, asexual and sexual. Vegetative reproduction occurs by the formation of fragments, that is fragmentation, or by means of Aicheidia and Soridia. Asexual reproduction takes place by Oidia formation, Conidia formation, or by the formation of pycnospores. Now, sexual reproduction is with definite male and female sex organs. So, regarding the asexual reproduction in lichens, Oidia are small and thin-walled bodies formed from the fungal hyphae of lichens. They get released from the parent lichen, come in contact with suitable algal components and form new lichen thalli. In several lichens, the fungal component forms conidia or conidiophores. Conidia get released from the lichen, form new fungal mycelia, which in turn come in contact with suitable algal components and form new lichen thalli. Pycnospores, these are conidia formed in flask-shaped structures called as pycnidia, which remain embedded in the thallus. Pycnospores get liberated from the lichen and form new fungal mycelia. They come in contact with suitable algal component and form new lichen thalli. So this is the structure of a pycnidia with pycnospores. You can see the flask-shaped pycnia with pycnidiospores formed inside. Now, the sexual reproduction in lichens, only the fungal partner of the lichen has the potential for sexual reproduction. Ascolichens and basidiolichens are capable of reproducing sexually. In ascolichens, the sexual reproduction is by the formation of definite sex organs, which result in the formation of fruiting bodies like apothecia or perithecia. The male sex organ is called as spermogonia or pycnia, and the female sex organ is called as carpogonia or ascogonia. Ascolichens may be monoecious or dioecious, depending upon whether the male and female sex organs are seen in the same thallus or in separate thalli. Now, regarding spermogonia, they are flask-shaped or pitcher-shaped structures lying embedded on the upper surface of the thallus. They open out by an opening called as osteole. The spermogonial cavity is filled with fertile and sterile hyphae. The fertile hyphae lining the cavity are called as spermatophores or pycnophores. They bud off male reproductive bodies called as spermatia or pycnospores. Spermatia are unicellular, uninucleate, non-motile, colorless male gametes and are released through a slimy fluid that oozes out through the osteole and then is disseminated by wind. Carpogonia or ascogonia are elongated elongated and basally coiled female sex organs lying embedded in the upper cortex of the thallus. Their helically coiled basal portion is called as oogonium, and the erect and extended terminal portion is called as trichogyne. Now, the basal portion, that is the oogonium, it contains the egg nucleus. The fertilization process: the spermatia, which are carried by wind, land on the sticky tip of the trichogyne of the carpogonium. Plasmogamy results in the formation of dikaryon. Now, the male nucleus, it passes down to the oogonium. Several septate ascogenous hyphae are developed from the dikaryon of the carpogonium. Now, the ascogenous hyphae are septate and dikaryotic. The ultimate or penultimate cell of each ascogenous hyphae develops into an ascus through crozier formation in the same way as in ascomycotin. In fact, all the sexual reproduction process in the case of ascolichens is very similar to that seen in the case of subdivision ascomycotina. Now, the karyogamy, it occurs in the ascus mother cell followed by meiosis and mitosis, resulting in the formation of 8 ascospores in each ascus. Simultaneous with this, sterile hyphae are formed around the ascogonium, ascogenous hyphae and developing assay. As a result, a fruiting body called as ascocarp is formed. Now, the structure of ascocarp, the wall of the ascocarp is formed of either fungal hyphae alone or by both algal and fungal layers. Its central part is formed of acai and a sterile tissue called as haematicium. Haematicium consists of 4 different elements, namely paraphysis, periphysis, paraphysoids and periphysoids. Now, paraphysis, they arise from the base of the ascocarp and they grow vertically upward. Periphysis, they arise from the side of the osteolar canal and protrude out of the osteol. Paraphysoids, they arise by the stretching of the tissue of the ascocarp, and periphysoids, they arise from the roof of the ascocarp and grow vertically downward. Now, this figure shows the different elements of haematicia, that is paraphysis. You can see the filaments growing from the base of the cavity, and the paraphysoids, which are formed by the extension of the tissue inside, and periphysis, they are formed from the tip of the tip near the osteol, and they come outside, and periphysoids, they grow vertically downwards from above. Internally, an ascocarp has 3 zones, namely thecium, epithecium and hypothecium. Thecium is the central zone formed of acai and haematicium. Epithecium is the terminal zone formed by the tips of paraphysis projecting beyond the acai. And hypothecium is the basal zone formed by loosely packed fungal hyphae. So you can see that in this figure, the apothecium shows the various structures. There is a portion called as epithecium, and then the hymenium and the subhymenium. Economic importance: Cladonia rangifera is also called as reindeer moss and is used as food for reindeers. Lecanora esculenta and Parmelia are edible species. Proxella montagni is used as a litmus dye, and Usnea is a source of usnic acid, which is a medicine. I have attached a word file and forwarded it in the WhatsApp group regarding the details of economic importance of lichens, and the ecological importance also are mentioned in that word file. You can go through that. Ecological importance: they are the pioneers in weathering process, that is the breaking of rocks and soil formation, and they are also indicators of air pollution, means they will be seen only in places where the pollution is less or almost nil. Now, the type that we have to study in lichens is Usnea, and it belongs to the subclass ascolichens and is a fruticose lichen. Usnea is a fruticose lichen. It is cylindrical to ribbon-like and much branched thallus. It is attached to the trunks of trees by rhizoid-like outgrowths called as rhizines. Usnea grows erect or pendant, with the main branch bearing many lateral branches. Color of thallus is gray, green or greenish-yellow. Several conspicuous bristles or fibrils cover the thallus. The lateral branches bear large plate-like apothecia terminally. Their margins are also fringed with bristle-like structures. Usnea is an example for a heteromerous lichen. The algal component is restricted to a specific zone or layer called as the algal zone. and a cross section of the thallus shows cortex, algal zone, medulla and a central chondroid axis. So this is the cross section of a lichen thallus showing the four different regions. Now regarding the cortex, it is the outermost region of the thallus, which is generally thick and protective. The hyphae in this region are very closely interwoven. The spaces among these hyphae are filled with a mucilaginous substance. Algal zone consists of algal cells and a tangled network of loosely interwoven fungal hyphae. The phycobiont is a unicellular green alga called as protococcus. The algal cells were earlier misunderstood as sex cells, gonadia, hence this layer was earlier called as gonadial layer. It is the photosynthetic region of the lichen thallus. Medulla is a broad zone where the hyphae are loosely packed with much interspaces. And the central chondroid axis, where the hyphae are very closely interwoven, giving a pseudo-parenchymatous appearance. Now the reproduction, vegetative reproduction and sexual reproduction are seen in Asnia. Vegetative reproduction takes place by fragmentation and by formation of structures called as soridium. Fragmentation occurs by aging or by accidental breakage. Soridia are small rounded granules that develop on the surface of the thallus. Each soridium contains one or more algal cells closely surrounded by fungal hyphae. Soridia are dispersed by wind. Some species of Asnia, like Asnia quomosa, soridia are born in localized pustule-like areas of the thallus called as soralia. Sexual reproduction is performed by the fungal partner. If the mycobiont is an ascomycetous fungus, the male and female sex organs are called as spermogonium and carpogonium respectively, that we have seen earlier also. Spermogonium is a flask-shaped structure opening outside by the osteole. The cavity of the spermogonium is covered by many fertile and sterile hyphae. The fertile hyphae produce non-motile spermatia. Carpogonium is produced on the ascogonial filament. It is many-celled and specialized filament having two portions, namely a lower coiled portion called as the carpogonium and or the ascogonium, and the upper straight portion which is called as the trichogonium. The cells of the ascogonial filaments are uninucleate. The liberated spermatia produced from the spermogonia get attached to the trichogyne. The intervening walls dissolve and the nucleus of the spermatium passes into the ascogonium, resulting in dikaryotization. The dikaryon divides by conjugate division and the cells of the ascogonium become diplodized. From the ascogonium, ascogenous hyphae develop. Asci are produced from the terminal or subterminal cells of the ascogenous hyphae. Each ascus bears 8 ascospores. Asci are intermingled with many sterile paraphyses. So the development of the fruiting body is just like that we have discussed in the general discussion about the lichens. The structure of the apothecium, the fruiting body of Asnia is called as apothecium. Apothecium is a saucer-shaped structure produced on a long stalk. Each apothecium contains a large number of asci, which are intermingled with sterile hyphae called as paraphyses. The asci and paraphyses are closely packed to form a continuous fertile layer called the hymenial layer or the hymenium, also called as the thecium. Beneath the hymenium is a region consisting of a dense mass of sterile tissue called as subhymenium, which consists of closely packed and interwoven hyphae. Below the subhymenium is the hypothecium, which forms the main body of the apothecium. Hypothecium contains loosely arranged hyphae internally and compactly arranged peridium externally. Hypothecium contains the algal zone. Thank you.